So I want to introduce our first series of speakers, and they're coming to us from Poland. Dr. Sebastian, who I think is joining us from some type of rooftop. He's got something going on a roof. Can you guys do me a favor and unmute yourself? Come on, guys, turn on your cameras. Turn on your cameras. There you are.
Hello. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hello, hello, hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. It's great to see you guys. Well, first, you're in a, why a rooftop?
Yes, you are right. As we discussed last time, I promised you that I will try to be much more enthusiastic and show you how Warsaw is beautiful. That's why I got on my roof, just to show you during our seminar how Warsaw is beautiful. I invite you all of you to Poland, because it's really amazing city. Awesome. Capital of Poland, by the way.
How high it is?
I think that about 40 meters. It's not so high. However, the view behind of me is beautiful, you know.
And the weather is good. Then, awesome.
All right. And then joining us from his Uber. Now, what are you doing in your car? Why are you in your car?
There is very important reason why I'm here, because this car, specific car, is a very important story, a part of a SmartKey story.
All right.
Interesting.
Take us away. Tell us about SmartKey.
Please.
Okay, then SmartKey story was began about 3 years ago. There was a meeting with me and my friends. After a while, we sat at the pub and we start discussing about what car do you like? What car do you prefer to drive, maybe? And obvious choice was Ferrari, Lamborghini, etc. But everyone told that I want to try to drive Ford Mustang. Okay, Ford Mustang, it's not so expensive car, yes? And we was six of us. And we decide to buy one car because we want to share between ourselves. Because all of us have, at this time, families. And maybe it will be some tricky part to convince my wife, hey, honey, I will buy Ford Mustang because I want it. But if we could buy one and share between friends, it could be possible. And at that time, okay, I figure out how to do it and how to do the sharing, this part of sharing. And I know already IoT devices that could open and close the cars without any keys. And now I'm figure out how to do application without application, because there is, at the beginning, it was only for fun, just for friends. And we figure out how to use blockchain. We create a token, special token. Now I know that this kind of token, its name is NFT tokens.
Okay.
We create some special tokens, spread this token, share between our friends, the amount equal to the money they give us to this car. And we can use at this time ordinary crypto wallet to share and store this token. That means we don't need any special IT application, and we don't need special servers or IT clouds, anything. We need only this device. This device was connected directly to the blockchain, and everything is placed on the blockchain. That's why we create at this time the first most secure car key in the world.
Cool. Because so how many people own your car?
Yeah, so can you first, do you have the car key with you? Does it look like a normal key? Is it just your smartphone? What is it?
Everything is automated. You can imagine that you as a user, you have maybe keys equal to possess this car for 2 days. You go to this car, send a transaction, this key transaction between your wallet and a wallet directly stick to the car, and this car will open you, because the only way to get this NFT token, this key token, is to get this key from the owner of this device. And this simple way show us the possibilities that kind of technology, we called it smart key at the beginning. And this kind of technology could also be used also with hotels, with apartments, with other use cases when you want to share a keys. We create...
But gentlemen, help me out here. So I hear what you're saying, but yeah. I'm kind of puzzled. It sounds like this technology has already existed for a long time. But you're saying now that it's on the blockchain, you're utilizing blockchain just to enhance it. But yeah. Is this really evolutionary? It sounds like, revolutionary. It sounds like just evolutionary. It's 1.0 to 2.0. Is it a game changer? I don't hear the game changing aspect yet.
I think, yes, of course, it's a level evolution of this kind of application that can manage and open your door. But using blockchain is a real revolution in the world. Why? Because blockchain is open source and available for everyone. And we figure out how to use blockchain to convince other companies that I already have similar products, similar services, like car sharing company, bike sharing, scooter sharing companies, Airbnb, and et cetera, because there is a specific problem in the world. There is a lack of communication standard between those smart solutions, smart IoT solutions, because those companies are compete each other. There is no any worldwide connection standard to connect directly, but not directly. That's why we are using blockchain. We compare this technology to the Bluetooth. Of course, you can create your own smartphone with Bluetooth, and other producers can create headphones with Bluetooth also. And the customers have guarantee that he can use it easily and combine and use both of this product as one. And blockchain changing everything, because till that time, big corporation and many, many companies, they don't see any threats to use the blockchain. Yes.
I'm watching people in the chat over at YouTube, because understand we're streaming this over on YouTube also. Someone says this technology is so smart. I'm still a bit lost on something, and maybe Christina, you could help me translate this better. It sounds like this is just using blockchain to do something that something already else does, or do you see?
I guess my question would be, will people understand that they are using something on blockchain? And is there a difference if they use this without blockchain and if they use it with blockchain?
I can tell you
one reason, and then I will ask Sebastian about his opinion, because one of the reasons was, if you can imagine that you can store and use your key for your private home, and you are staying in the front of your home, there is raining and you want to go inside, and of course your lock don't want to lock out. Why? Because everybody knows that most secure application is a bank application, or Google is most secure place maybe. I remember a few times, even with my banks, there was I don't know the reason, but there was a break. I can't use my bank for a few hours. And why? Because they are centralized. And there is a problem with this, because if you can imagine that if you even once you will stay in front of your house and there will be raining, that I'm sure that it will be last time that you will use this these keys. Blockchain have this this advantage above ordinary IT systems, that blockchain never stops because it's fully decentralized. This is the one reason why only blockchain could store so important thing for people's life, like keys for your goods, for your offices, for your car, and etc. That also gives you another advantage above ordinary IT system, because you can easily use blockchain anonymous, fully anonymous, without any registration.
Let me go to Dr. Sebastian. Dr. Sebastian, I know you wanted to bring something up. By the way, I like how the two of you have found a way to get pink in both of your shirts.
Yeah.
Very impressive.
Yeah, that's true. Again, what is about the pink color, huh?
The pink color is I love magenta, by the way. That's I just would like to take your attention on that. You should pay attention on me. Can try to answer your question. There is evolution or revolution. I think that both of two titles suit for this project, because first of all, I'm not anymore in Orange. That is true. However, I met Szymon 8-9 months ago, and he just briefly explained me what is the heart of the system. And I think the revolution is because we engage telco into the blockchain. And it is not the internal reason. There is really pure city case. And that is, I think, revolution, because telcos, as you know, in general, from the history, they are responsible for the security of connectivity from 2 to 5G currently. It means very advanced mobile access. And what has been done around this project, we join two areas, blockchain and IoT. It means that we are creating completely new area of the business, blockchain, Internet of Things. Around this case, as Szymon mentioned, you have at least two important topics. IoT is controlling the infrastructure, is giving the highest security because telecommunication network is really securing the connectivity. It means it's very secure, especially for the cities. And blockchain giving us democracy of the access and flexibility of the standard. It means that if you are touching the city, hundreds of different devices, hundreds of different sensors, many applications, okay, you need something which really works on top of those thousands of different elements of the
smart city. Did I understand correctly that you started experimenting with that 7 years ago?
Seven months.
Okay. So where are we on this path? How would you see the development of the IoT and blockchain in, let's say, a year from now?
I think that we started something brand new, especially for telcos, I personally believe that we really...
Telcos is telecommunications. For those
telecommunication,
who don't know.
Telecommunication, different telecoms around the world. We've done it in Poland with Orange. However, now the way we showed is for all of telecoms around the world. Why? Because telecoms plus blockchain with a very smart use case really is the game changer around the city. Try to imagine that through the one access, which is fully democratic way of reusing it, you can manage sensors, you can manage traffic lights, you can manage all of accesses around the city. And what is really king around this game, there is the simplicity. There is really simplicity. Even from my personal experience, I just met many different clouds in the one city, 3, 5, 6, 7, each cloud for different solution. If you are using this kind of way of the service, which reuse blockchain, you are really making the standardization around it. That is really big revolution for the cities. I'm strongly believing it, you know.
Okay, guys, so this to us. What will you be showing off in Dubai?
In Dubai, yes, we have large exhibition stand, and we mainly will show live use cases. Because first use case when we tried to use our technology was the use case when literally blockchain saves people's life, because we have built solution when car ambulances and fire workers could easily go and get inside to the gated communities using an NFT blockchain based keys.
Will you bring ambulances to the exhibition center?
It was idea to do it, but we will
reconstruct a whole city where we can demonstrate how blockchain could be applied.
But you need for this reason big stage, you know, because you as well have the fireman truck, you know.
We should be
as
ambitious.
Well. All right. So guys, last thing before we go, which we're really excited to see you. If people want to find out more about what you're doing, what's the website?
Website is smartkeyplatform.io. Yes.
Okay.
There
and then
you will find what more, and try to find us also on YouTube channel. There is some videos about use cases.
Guys, we really appreciate you sharing time with us. We're looking forward to seeing you in Dubai, October 17th through the 20th. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Drive safely, Simon.